Welcome back to the slimy dungeon.
And your worst nightmare.
So you were saying last episode, before I cut you off and refused to dignify your question with a response, you're wondering if, what was it, battle?
The blade, scalebound.
Scalebound.
But, there, yeah, was going real to, quick, yeah. These are orbs. They're the version of halos. But they just rack up as halos like anything else, because that's... Yeah, they could at least put like the orb in the middle of the halo or something, up in the little counter.
Yeah,
anything.
Yeah. Yeah. The more I see this game, the more I realize this isn't done.
Right.
Like this just really doesn't come off as finished.
It's so frustrating that this got worse reviews than one, or this got better reviews than one.
Yes.
Like by such a landslide.
It technically is less of a mess than one. Like, one had terrible screen tearing and frame rate problems.
It did, but I mean, it's not like that's what they were complaining about.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, some of these new demons are pretty cool. I mean, look at that guy.
Total prick. See what I did?
Pretty accurate.
Yeah. Tomorrow's mine.
This battle scene is better than the first battle scene it has.
I can't hear it. It is really buried right now. Is it really different?
Maybe it just cuts in later in it. But yeah, I feel like this is the second battle scene that started. This is what played in the intro, though. Like, the first level had this song.
Okay.
And then we've been hearing some other battle scene that...
Yeah, I think those are two parts of the same song.
Maybe.
Oh. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it is.
Can you mark that? I want that pictured. I'm gonna be using that for the rest of the parts. Or something. Hopefully. Unless it just looks bad and I'm like, shit. Remember the time of Sonic Adventure and all the thumbnails looked terrible and that was great? Cause like, here's a zoom in of Amy Rose's face in a very derby animation.
An animation, you say?
Yeah.
That game.
Yeah. Yeah, so now that I'm seeing the whole game's plot through, I'm fully understanding everything you were saying about, like, not understanding, like, if it was better than one, and like, how weird it all came together. Yeah, this is a shambling mess of a plot.
Right, and then with the boss fights being the way they are, like,
it's a shambling mess of a game.
Right.
Yeah. Things don't connect at all. And then the plot literally doesn't make sense by the end.
So, guess what it's time for?
Oh, man. Nonsense?
Another boss fight.
What?
Yeah! One. This game!
Man, you weren't kidding when you were saying that it should probably just have more normal game.
Right? I definitely, like... I enjoy normal game parts of these games. I'll oftentimes win in the boss fights. I didn't know anybody. And that's just not... in this as much.
He's clearly not even coming for you. Kick, 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 kick. Olay. Oh, Crispin Freeman, you're so sugoi.
And here I thought I was your type. I guess I had you all wrong.
Step away, Umbra Witch. This is not your fight.
Actually, it is.
Chuggies.
Now I need to play Uncharted 3 to see which is worse. Bob takes a deep sip of liquor. Like, oh god. I don't want to think of both of them at the same time. It's too much. It's too much!
Yeah, basically.
Axiom Verge, the biggest disappointment since Bayonetta 2. Clearly, I'm just going to write a video game review show that's me doing the critic's stick.
Good.
Not really, but no. People will like it, and I will hate them for it. Ooh.
So the slice is really cool, but it has a problem. It's almost Virgil levels of not having moveset.
Yeah, I always find it really weird in action games when they have weapons that are like that.
Yeah, and this game does that, I believe, with other weapons too, and it's like...
And they're the new ones, right?
Yes, so like the chainsaws.
They recycled a ridiculous amount of weapons,
mm-hmm.
And then they barely made moves for the new ones.
Yeah.
Fucking A.
Yeah, and then I'd say during one of the breaks, but we were talking about how you get a lot of the same abilities from the first game, too. It's like... Guys, what?
You just made an unnecessary amount of cutscenes and boss fights.
So the good stuff, that thing is crazy.
Yes, that thing's fucking nuts.
So this is that other scene I was talking about where it kind of goes crazy again.
And yeah.
On the sea of blood and whatnot.
Yeah. I bet this would be even crazier if you had any context.
Right.
Or character motivation that made this battle, like, anything other than two assholes cockfighting. Just saying.
Oh, Drake, need to stop him.
You know who's a really good character? That guy from Uncharted 2, you know why?
Why?
That guy was scary as hell when he yelled Drake's name.
Good reason, I guess.
Yeah. They were. Just something about him being like, Drake! And you're just like, oh, fuck yeah, I'm gonna hide.
It is kind of upsetting that action games, really, there hasn't been as good a like rival character as Virgil since Devil May Cry 3. Like, I believe
like
he is...
in their design?
Right, in the design of like the way those fights play out and... the motivation behind them fighting. Like, it feels really cool.
Now, this is gonna sound really harsh.
Yeah.
But I'm being honest. What is Virgil's motivation for fighting Dante?
Virgil just wants power. That is it. It is really simple, but they have, like, the back history of us being family that makes it kind of neat.
Okay, so what's Dante's motivation for fighting Virgil?
Stopping him. And having fun by fighting.
Okay, yeah, I was like, all I remember is them just cockfighting.
Right. At least at the beginning of the game, by the end, it is kind of like the whole...
Yeah.
I'm fighting to stop you from doing this.
Because dad? Question mark? Little one. It's not that little! Crispin Freeman, what? His beautiful eyes. I mean, I agree. Mechanically, at least. I'm not so sure about the story. I feel like it's not a high bar.
It isn't. It really isn't. I mean...
on the story side, but it definitely is a high bar on the gameplay side.
Like, I think John got close and Bayonetta won.
Close, yeah. But then, like, there was no good final delivery on that.
Right, it wasn't like that's how they ended the game, and even the final fight with her wasn't, like... all that great.
Yeah, no, I wasn't. So, you know, that was a 7-minute long episode too, but, you know, that actually had, like...
I was playing it for about 7 minutes.
Yeah, instead of 30 or whatever. God damn it, Lucas, shut up. Let's keep going.
Keep it rolling, all
keep
right.
Keep it rolling. How many chapters are in this?
I think 20.
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't remember,
I
man.
I think that's...
Maybe...
I think it's 18.
Maybe.
I'm gonna look it up. Just because, like, we're burning through these chapters at a rate of which I'm like, oh god, is this game 6 hours long?
Yeah, you go through them really fast when they're just all fight scenes. Or one fight, rather.
Yeah. I'm like, the whole game is fight scenes. I don't know. I don't know what game you're looking at.
This is... Welcome to hell, love. Too late to repent. These These are the gates. Whatever your friend did to get on the other side of these, let's just say she's not having a good day.
But yeah, like, Virgil grew in interesting ways for each fight. Like, in the second one, he had the Beowulf, so it was having to deal with a whole new moveset.
Yes!
With that.
And it was fucking brilliant how they tied that into him getting it.
Yeah.
16.
16, okay.
We are halfway through this game at the end of this chapter. In just the sheer number of chapters. Probably more than that, time-wise.
Maybe. There are a lot of cutscenes.
That's true. But I feel like there were a lot of cutscenes in chapter 1 and 2.
There were. So you're right. It probably is, like, at least half.
We're on 8, so chapter 6 had fucking 30 minutes of cutscene or something.
Yeah. You're right on that fact.
Fucking A! Like, okay, we're gone. I wish I liked how the platforming felt in Bayonetta. I know that's not the point of the game.
Right.
But sometimes they make it the point of the game.
Right.
Double dicker! Is that really its hope? There are tiny legs. Uh-oh.
This isn't Persona. They don't have that guy.
Oh, okay. See, this is where I'd make a joke saying that Bob was talking about the gay character or the guy with latent homosexuality, and I don't know that game well enough to make that joke, so I'm just gonna describe the joke and
then you guys can fill it in.
You Persona fans can be like, oh, that's a good one. Good going, Dan. That was funny. Yeah. I'm trying to remember where we started recording this one. Where did we start recording this one?
I don't know. I think it was inside that fish. Like, we got through that level, and then we beat the boss.
Wait, was that inside a fish?
That thing ate us, that manta ray thing.
Is that how? Okay.
Yeah, and then all that stuff happened inside him. That's why he exploded at the end of it.
Okay.
I know, it's hard to follow sometimes.
A little bit. It's not even that I'm just ignoring the game. I really am just... Oh! Neat! That's this game?
There we go.
So, that means all of chapter 7, right?
Yeah, basically. Wait, no, chapter 7 was half the first boss. Maybe it wasn't.
Yeah, I guess we started recording once you landed and beat up that rock, right? Like, you beat up that rock at the beginning of this
part,
right?
Yes,
yes. Okay, so this part's running a bit long, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it is.
Hmm.
We check and it's like been 2 minutes since we started a new part.
We're just like fucking fuck you guys, come back tomorrow.
GigaBoots has been brought to you by the support of our producers Vincent Povirk and Cywolf via our Patreon. Consider becoming a GigaBoots patron today.